Yo, what's going on, guys? Welcome to the channel. Why am I dressed up today? I'm about to give you guys a little EP personal security hack as far as carrying items in bags. Sometimes you're not able to carry everything that you want on your persons, and you still have to blend into that corporate environment, that executive environment. So stay tuned. I hope you guys enjoy it. This is Vactive. Stay in the fight. If I could remember all the reasons why I started this, pocket full of seeds, but can't remember where the garden is. But soon as I find it, best believe that I'll be raising trees. Cut one down to make a bed out of it for the major leagues. Representing G&D. Alright, here I am, all dressed up in my suit with my cool tactical backpack on. I don't know how many of you guys have seen this before, but I've definitely seen it before, and it is not a good look. This does not look very professional. An oversized tactical backpack with a bunch of patches all over it. Not only is it not professional, you're not blending into the environment. You look like an intern that just got the job. And again, you're gonna be walking around with this. It's gonna end up ruining your suit. You're gonna have wrinkles all over it, making you look highly unprofessional. Remember guys, perception is reality. So let's see if we can do a little bit better than this. There we go, that's a little bit better. Oh, no, no. No rifle range bag? Oh, all right. Okay, here's another option. A smaller commercial backpack that you can find pretty much at any store. It's a little bit better. It doesn't look as bad, but you're still not blending in. Again, you're still looking like that intern. You still have the backpack on your back, which is going to be ruining your jacket or your shirt or whatever it is. But remember, the name of the game is trying to blend in and not draw attention to yourself. You want to look like you belong in the environment. Alright guys, and here it is. So my choice, my go-to when I know I'm going to be working in or going to a lot of different corporate settings or working around high-level executives is going to be the simple laptop bag. I feel that this is really overlooked and underutilized. It's not as fancy as a briefcase. A briefcase has limited options as far as how much you can pack in there, whereas a laptop bag has a lot of different pockets, zippers, and things like that. So it's really functional, and it also has the strap, right, that you can still be hands-free, you can throw it around, and it works almost like a sling bag. And if you're working long periods and extended periods of time, you know that there's certain things you're not going to be able to carry on your body. Currently, I have no use for having a laptop on me at all times, so I'm going to go ahead and ditch the laptop and fill this bag with all the things I'm going to need. So remember guys, this is just a basic of what I'm pretty much going to be taking with me everywhere I go, no matter the setting. What I've done here is I've just thrown it into the laptop bag so you can see how I set it up. And of course, there's going to be certain things that I'm going to leave at home if I know that I'm not going to need them. Now remember, situation always dictates, so depending on your principal, the type of client you're working with, and their security needs, that's also going to determine the type of things that you take with you. And there's also some pretty good ideas in here for your own personal preparedness, whether you're working in a security capacity or not, just things that you always want to think about to keep yourself ready and prepared. Let's go ahead and open up this bag. You don't have to overthink this. There's nothing high speed here. Probably the most important thing that I always have to remember and always take with me is going to be the IFAC, the individual first aid kit, along with the tourniquet. In case I need to treat any type of bleeding, any type of first aid for my client, for myself, this is going to be in here. This is going to be pretty much in every bag and everything that I take with me. On the side here, I just have my knife clipped onto it, just for ease of transportation. Sometimes I don't want to have it on my body if I have to go through some sort of screening process. I don't want to have to go through the time of taking it off and putting it. So once I get to where I'm going to be, then I will unclip this from here and then put it on my belt and keep it on my persons at all time. Same thing with the flashlight. This will be my main flashlight that I carry. And then this is just the ring, the Thyrim flashlight ring on here. Here's hand sanitizer for myself and more importantly for my client. Hand sanitizer and some gum. A couple little key tips that you want to keep on you at all times as well for your principal. Okay, I should have said this is the second most important thing. I'm not going anywhere without one of these. I know I need to find a better energy caffeine source, but right now this is it, zero sugar. Trust me, if you're doing those long days standing around on your feet, it's gonna get boring. You're gonna need some type of energy. You can do coffee, you can do tea, whatever it is. The 5-hour energy drinks are really good, little small ones, because you can throw them in your pocket. You can throw two or three of them in here and you're good to go. Nutrition is also important. You might not have time to eat, so make sure you find something that's packable, something that is not that bad for you,
that you're going to be able to snack on throughout the day. I really like Clif Bars, beef jerky, dry fruit, or just fresh fruit if you can put them in little baggies, Ziploc bags, throw them in here. Here we have two things for low light situations. I like the glow sticks because they're cheap, they're easy, they're light. You can throw them in here. You can use them to throw them into dark rooms or whatever the case. Give one to your principal, give one to your client, tell them to hold on to it. That way you don't lose them. Not the light, your principal. Another good option and idea to have with you at all times is a headlamp. This is gonna go in all of my bags as well, and it's gonna go with me everywhere. But in relation to what we're talking about here, being in a corporate environment, things like that, you might find yourself in a high-rise building. The power goes out, all the lights are gonna be down. You're gonna have to be taking the stairs. In a natural disaster, there might be a power outage as well. So you're gonna wanna have both of your hands free to be able to grab onto your principal, open doors, move stuff out of the way, whatever it is. This is just gonna allow you to have both your hands mobile and still have a light source. Okay, so next up is gonna be the external battery or power bank. I know there's a bunch of different ones out there. There's some name brand ones. It doesn't really matter which one you get. I actually have a Mophie one that can clip onto my phone, but this is an external battery that can charge different type of electronic devices. All you wanna make sure is that it can hold a charge and that it has the ports and the stuff that you need. You can find really cheap ones on Amazon and things like that. You don't have to like break the bank to get one of these. So I think it's really important to have one of these. Nowadays, we use our phones for so much, navigation, texting back and forth. In this line of work, you definitely, and anytime, you don't wanna ever find yourself without any type of form of communication. For us, we're constantly texting with the principals, their assistants, their team. There's always a lot of movement going on, so the batteries drain pretty fast. Don't forget your cord. Obviously, it's important if you're gonna be charging your phone and connecting it to the external battery, but then also have the option to be able to plug it into a wall so that you don't have to deplete this if it's not absolutely necessary. Another idea, and something that I've been starting to do more and more, is carry an extra shirt with me whenever I'm working, whether it's in this sort of environment or any other environment. If for whatever reason my principal decided that they wanted to stop somewhere on the way home or go to dinner or something like that, and the setting is a little bit less formal, then this here is a little bit less formal than what I'm wearing right now, and so it would still allow me to blend into that environment. Also, if throughout the day that I'm working I spill something, if I find myself running around and sweating in what I'm wearing now, then this also allows me to change and still maintain that professional appearance. And lastly is a pair of work gloves. And what's not shown here, which I usually carry in conjunction with the work gloves, is a multi-tool or a Leatherman. I don't know where mine is. I've been looking for it the past few days, so it's definitely on my list to replace that. I think I was using it and it either fell out, fell on the ground, and I haven't been able to find it. So the reason that I carry these two items is inevitably your principal, their team, or you yourself will find that you're gonna need to fix something on the fly, grab something, bend something, move something out of the way, and you just having that tool on you is just money in the bank. If there's some sort of natural disaster, an earthquake, and we've got things that are broken, things that have fallen, you have glass everywhere, you wanna be able to put something on, some sort of barrier, so you're not compromising yourself, you're not cutting yourself and doing all these crazy things that you shouldn't have to be doing. These are just gonna be a form of protection to help you out in that scenario. And that's pretty much it, guys. This is just the basics. I hope that was helpful. Maybe you got an idea or two from it. Again, remember, a couple of these things can be used just in your own personal preparedness. It doesn't have to be for the sake of you working in the security capacity. For instance, the headlamp, the medical kit, and an external battery are probably some basic stuff that you could keep with you at all times. The situation is gonna dictate, so there are some things that I may or may not include in here, but again, we don't always show every card we have, right? That wraps up this video. I appreciate you guys watching. If you have any other recommendations for essential items, staple items that should go in this bag, please drop them in the comment section below. I'm by far no expert, and I'm always looking for feedback. I'm always looking to learn, so please leave them there. Like, share, and subscribe if you haven't. It really helps out the channel. And if you want, check out vactivefit.com. It's the blog where I go into a little bit more in depth in written form along with the videos. So I'll see you guys on the next one. Stay safe, stay in the fight.